far this year, the PWBA crowned a new Queens champion who won her second title of the year. Two college teammates joined forces to win a doubles event. Two young champions won again. While two outstanding PWBA veterans continued their winning ways. The 1980s Bowler of the Decade proved it takes determination to win on the PWBA Tour. And last week, this PWBA champ won her third major at the U.S. Open. What's next? Find out as the PWBA visits Lexington, Kentucky for the start of the PWBA Summer Tour. Today's opener features three veterans, Marianne DeRupo, Anne-Marie Dugan, and last week's U.S. Open champ, Kim Adler. The survivor will face off against defending champ, Michelle Feldman, and the winner there will challenge top seed Leanne Barrett for the title. Welcome to the home of many of the top thoroughbreds in the world, Lexington, Kentucky. Today we're inside Collins Bowling Center's Eastland, where the top women bowlers in the world will compete for the Lady Ebonite Classic title. Hi everyone, I'm Jan Schmidt, along with my partner, who is a thoroughbred in bowling, Lisa Wagner. Now, Lisa, let's get right to it. In the number one post position, Leanne Barrett, she's having a great year, but it could all be in jeopardy.
Well, a win tonight would mark her third title of 1999, and her hopes for Bowler of the Year would just soar. But there is a twist to this story. Right before last week's U.S. Open, she hurt her back. Last night, the pain was very evident, and even in today's earlier practice session, even more so.
Well, we'll have to watch it and see how that pain progresses tonight and throughout the swing. In her number four position, Kim Adler. She does not have any injuries, but she's battling exhaustion after 11 straight days of pro-ams and competition.
That's right. Now, Jane, you have to remember that at the very same time that Kim Adler was winning last week's U.S. Open in Connecticut, we were already here in Kentucky bowling practice session and pro-am. And with very, very little preparation, she still managed two 300 games and qualified third.
Well, we'll see if she can manage 12 straight days right now, because she'll be joined by Anne-Marie Dugan and Marianne DeRupo for the opening match. Let's bowl.
And there's what's fast becoming the traditional handshake of the opening match. Low fives around. Once again, we're at Collins Bowling Center's Eastland.
But please step into my lovely establishment, Cedar House Lines, and Finney Ellis. Or Finney Ellis is just a Cedar House. My grandfather probably owns Gary. Have a wonderful day. In my hometown, I said.
Henry's opening shot coming up light, leaving a two pin.
What? They probably can't see. No. They probably can't see the
first look
there.
At Kim Adler.
They're probably all strike.
Coming up a little bit high, leaving a four pin. Henry Dugan, meanwhile, stepping up to shoot the two pin.
This was being very tight. There's quite a bit of conditioner on the lanes. They went 44 feet this week with the oil. So you may see a few of the balls going a little bit light, but all five players today found a way to adjust to that.
It was funny watching last night with that 44 feet, and you bowled on it, Lisa, but it looked like back to pre-resin days before the resin equipment was out. The balls didn't hit at all.
That's right. Kim Adler, who just saw make the four pin there, mentioned that it seemed like of the days of old when you played fallback shots, and that's where you saw the ball just fade to the right for a right-hander, and it just barely popped left at the end.
First look at Marianne DeRupo. Half pocket, leaving the seven pin.
Holy crap.
Anne-Marie Dugan, meanwhile, stepping up in the second. And missing the head pin right, a little bit of what you talked about, Lisa. Marianne going to cover her left side. Spare the seven pin. Oftentimes, Marianne will use three different balls, a spare ball for left, spare ball for right, and her strike shot. Now, last night, Marianne went crazy.
Yes, she did. Won six of her eight matches. She moved from 15th to 5th last night. What a charge by Marianne DeRupo. Look at the scores.
268 to 58 on a condition that was low scoring. And
quite relieved.
Yeah,
to make that
a big breath after that one. You know, talk about the scores. Combined average this week for these five finalists throughout the week was 216.54. However, on the television pair, their combined average was 241.36.
Sure, I don't believe there's anybody below 232 average on this pair.
Big strike for Kim Adler. So we talk about pairs playing differently. It was extremely evident this week that lanes 13 and 14 in this bowling center are very high scoring, at least on a condition like this.
I had to put both those balls in my bag. I failed my one ball.
Oh, going over Brooklyn, leaving a six pin. She almost wound up knocking that down.
It's all right. I said that one you want to show my client. Dead hooks. Dead hooks.
A little bit tentative here in the early going, but that's to be expected. Because the condition this week was pretty demanding. The averages were good because a lot of these players played the left holes.
Covers that spare. Now, fans in the Terre Haute area, you can join your favorite PWBA stars at the Terre Haute Bowling Center for the next Pro-Am on the PWBA Summer Tour. Call Rick Braden at 812-238-2911 for more Pro-Am information for the Clabber Girl Greater Terre Haute Open, beginning August 15th. So coming out and join us for that Pro-Am. Here's a look at the score. Kim Adler leading by one pin through the two frames so far. That would be one pin over Marianne DeRupo. Three pin lead over Anne-Marie Dugan. Anne-Marie up now in the third. And again, light, fortunate to just have the two pin. Now, as the players are coming light here, what kind of moves do you think they need to make?
Well, I think they definitely need to move their target left. Now, they said that they all played the hold to the left. Now, their target was a lot further left than it normally is for them. But that worked this week because the oil is so far down the lane. And I know that Anne-Marie is going to make that move. She's either going to do that, she's going to straighten up, probably go a little bit firmer, or she's going to switch balls probably to a more aggressive one.
Good point. So, all the players talked about how important equipment was this week.
Absolutely. Equipment and especially the surface on the bowling ball. They went to a very aggressive surface. Took some Scotch-Brite sandpaper to the equipment before we started.
See, Marianne defeated Anne-Marie throughout the week in match play and no finish on that ball. This is a real challenge for the players this week, and that's why you see a lot of the players that get more hand in the ball, more turn, were the ones that made the telecast.
Absolutely.
Light mixer for Anne-Marie. Marianne stepping up to shoot her spare. We mentioned she went from 15th to 5th last night, and that a huge accomplishment on this type of lane condition, any lane condition for that matter.
Sure, and she said that she pulled a ball off of her ball cart that she had not used before. She had sanded it up and put some more surface on it just before that flock and pulled it out for that round, and boy, did it work.
Kim Adler in the lead by 14 pins through three frames. She can make it 24 with another strike here. Kim's having a good year also. She's cashed in every event, and she's made all cuts but one. Fourth show on the year. So all in all, a very good year for Kim Adler. How about that five pin, Lisa?
Thought it was going to stand. You saw a lot of those hits this week.
Marianne DeRupo now up in the fourth. Coming up high, leaving a 6-10, and that's what you have to guard against. Trying not to open up the lane, you can pull it onto the nose. How did you play the lanes, Lisa?
Not very well.
You made the cut. Did you Where did you play on the lane?
Well, I played pretty much the middle part of the lane, right in the track area where most everybody would be playing, but I did opt for the outside once in a while.
Well, Kim Adler sitting on an early lead. We'll be right back with more from Collins Bowling Center East. The championship round finals of the Lady Ebonite Classic are being brought to you by MasterCard. There are some things in life money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. And by AMF Bowling Worldwide, the largest owner and operator of bowling centers in the world and one of the leading makers of bowling products. AMF always means fun. While we were gone, Kim Adler increased her lead to 37 pins. That 37-pin lead now over Marianne DeRupo. No players struck. Carrie's been very tough. Anne-Marie Dugan's had a little struggle with her spare shooting right now.
Well, has hooked by 2 10 pins so far, the sixth and seventh frame. Very uncharacteristic for Anne-Marie. There she says, way to go, like you're a good shot.
Back on track, she talked last night about how she did so well on her spare shooting, but you know, it's been since November of 98, since Anne-Marie's been on a telecast. There may be a little nerves there for her.
Well, and especially coming out on a tough condition, too. You know, a lot of times a player may look like they don't know what they're doing, they don't have a clue, but, you know, the condition could be a little different today, and if you're not sure, it's hard to make premium shots.
Coming up light 258, and the pins spread a little bit. They will have to stand that way, though, because it was pins that moved the other pins, so
that's
they
right.
won't get to respot it.
That's right. If the machine did it, then she could have it put back on, but the machine did not do it.
Another 10-pin for Marianne. Meanwhile, take a look at Kim Adler's shot.
Ball just sliding by. Look at that. Just doesn't really want to pick up a roll. Pin comes in between, sets that pin, the 5-pin, off a little bit too far to the right there, and it left her with a little bit more difficult spare.
Easily choppable this way. Covers it, no problem. I guess that's what happens sharp off of a U.S. Open victory.
That's right. Big smile of relief there.
Marianne covers that up, no problem on that 10-pin. Tournament stats for this week, 59 ladies only bowled. Averaged to cash low this week, 199.
Averaged match play, 205, and look at that, 214 to make it here. 2 300 guests this week, both by the ladies coming up on lane 14.
Anne-Marie Dugan showing she can fight back. She's like, wait a minute, I am a veteran, remember? Kim Adler, meanwhile, up in the ninth frame.
She will need to mark in the ninth or 10th with some good count if Anne-Marie strikes out.
Looks like a good shot. Boy, she is so direct, which is what you talked about all the players had to do this week.
Well, I tell you, on a condition like this, and early in the day right now when the lanes are going through a little bit of a transition, that is probably the best way to be. Anne-Marie has a lot more touch on the ball, a lot harder to read sometimes.
Man, whoa, did I drill that? Did you see that ball hook? Now I know Marianne worked on slowing her ball down. She changed her position of her feet, and that's been critical for her. She even looked slower on that shot.
That's right. She said that she had to get the ball straighter down the lane, so she closed her feet up. That closed her hips up.
That was Marianne we were talking about.
Right down there, you could see her feet together. They're side by side this time as she throws. Look at that, all 10 right in the pit. Normally she starts with the right foot further back, and that opens her hips up and let the ball go a little bit to the right. She does not want the ball to go to the right now, so they're closed.
Kim Adler leaving a 10-pin. You saw Anne-Marie Dugan leave a 7-pin a moment ago. It was a really nice shot. Could have been a 3-bagger. Unfortunate not to carry that. Kim Adler has basically wrapped this up. Just keeping that ball in play, shot after shot.
Staying clean, making the spares.
Well, I want to quickly mention, I know Anne-Marie wanted to thank some people for helping her out. Billy Orlikowski worked with her at the Open last week, and her husband, Pat, along with Brian Berg, worked with her on lengthening her span. but a special comment she wanted us to make, Stacy Ryder and Jim Lee. Jim Lee seriously ill at home. Stacy is Anne-Marie's doubles partner. Jim, on behalf of all of the bowling community and all of your friends, we wish you well and we're praying for you.
Absolutely, Jim.
Kim Adler now finishing out. And six, but it really doesn't matter. Score of 210 for Kim Adler. She is the best of the three, at least today. She'll move on, but first, Anna Miller Mackey gives us advice on bowling with the help of her niece, Adrian. This week's edition of the PWBA News takes us to another charity event as veterans Dana Miller-Mackey and Marianne DeRubo help athletes from a Special Olympics at a clinic in North Carolina. We also welcome back the PWBA's reigning player of the year, Carol Giannotti-Block, after rehabbing from elbow surgery. And we congratulate U.S. Open runner-up Linda Norrie Barnes on her July 17th marriage to PBA member Chris Barnes. We're back at Collins Bowling Center's Eastland for the semifinal match of the Lady Ebonite Classic. Kim Adler will start this match. Michelle Feldman had the choice, wants Kim to start.
I guess she kind of wants to put the pressure on the last week's U.S. Open champ, wants to put the pressure on her at the end. So start first, finish last. That's how I always remembered it.
11 national titles for Kim Adler, again, one coming last week. Trying to make it 12. Great opening shot.
Well, Kim Adler is going to stay out of trouble. Let's hope, now that I said that. She's going to stay out of trouble with the game that she has playing straight down the lane. You're going to see a little bit of a different look from this lady right here.
First look at Michelle Feldman, 5'6", defending champion of this event. It was held last year in Louisville, Kentucky at Executive Bowl. Leaving that nine pin, this tournament alternating between Louisville and Lexington. This is Michelle's first chance to defend a title. She's never made the show before after she's won.
Michelle has a very powerful game, probably the most powerful on our tour today. Look at the revs on that ball. She can splatter pins around with the best of them.
And even with her game and the equipment today, and watching her last night, there were so many times on this long conditioning pattern that she could not get the ball to hit.
That's right. We asked her what her key was to hit the pocket this week, and she said soft and softer. Now, if she has to be soft, what did the rest of us have to do? She had to play straighter up the lane, and said she had a lot of positive comments.
Big strike from Michelle Feldman. Kim Adler now stepping up in the second frame, working on a strike. And talking about slowing down, I mean, I don't think there was a player out here that didn't have to slow their ball speed down. Did you slow your ball speed?
Oh, absolutely. Had to.
Kim taking her time here. Always takes a little more time when you have to do something that you're not accustomed to doing. By Kim, and we asked her when it was that it hit her that she had won the U.S. Open.
It was like a scene out of the movie The Graduate, the last scene. I was on the shuttle bus from the rental car place returning to the airport. It was my first moment by myself to realize what the heck I just did. I just kind of sat there and just stood back. What did I do? You know, I couldn't believe it. It was more like a dream. It happened so quickly.
And she had no one to share it with, Lisa. Her aunt took home her trophy and jacket. The big check, I believe, Dan Leary from Strike 10 had, and Don Harris from the BPAA still had the real check.
That's right. She said if somebody would have asked her, she would have had to say, no, really, I did win.
Really, you're honest. Well, yeah. Show me something. Well, it's kind of a pretty cute story.
We just saw Kim with three in a row there, too.
She'll now up in the third, trailing by 20 pins. She can take it down to 10 with one more strike. Ooh, coming up high, leaving the 4-7. Look at how these ladies made it to the telecast. Leanne Barrett up there most of the week. Michelle Feldman big jump that second night, all the way to third, and that's when Anne-Marie Dugan made her big jump. Meanwhile, Marion DeRupo moving up all the way through the week. What happened that second night that everyone made a big jump there?
The lanes were a little bit different the second day. They broke down a little bit different, probably because of a lot of qualifying on Tuesday morning. People came out with different surfaces, different equipment, broke the lanes down just a little bit different than the first day. So I think they hooked a little bit more, and people liked that.
Well, Michelle Felbin now up in the fourth. Needs to get some strikes going. Kim Adler looks great. Big shot by Michelle. Kim Adler getting ready for the fourth frame here. Meanwhile, Dan Mason from Bank One with several of the Pro-Am winners, and along with Molly Thomas. A lot of the youth Pro-Am winners there. Did you bowl with the kids or the adults this week?
I bowled with adults. I had a later Pro-Am in the day, and we had a good time.
217 average for Kim Adler this week.
Definitely left of target that time, got a little bit soft. Goes through the nose, leaves herself 3-6-10.
Lisa, she just changed the position on her wristband. Now, why is she doing that?
She's going to flatten the ball out just a little bit. She doesn't want quite as much hook at this spare. You're probably not going to see her shoot this the way she normally would on a condition that hooks.
Because ordinarily, Kim Adler will remove her wristband to shoot these right side spares. So she's going to at least keep her wrist in a flat position and not let it break back.
That's right. And she's also going to move a little bit further right on the lane to make this. She's not going to go all the way to the left gutter.
Oh, and a big break. Not the way not the way they say you should shoot it. And there she goes, cupping that wristband back.
Well, ideally, you're going to want to get the ball to the right of the 3-pin. She got a very good break getting the 6-pin off the wall into the 10. A lot of times you'll get the 6-pin around the 10, leave it 7-2, and say, hey, well, start over.
Kim Adler up by 17 pins. Working on a spare, though, Michelle Feldman on a strike. Another stubborn 10-pin, a lot of those this week because of the length of the conditioner.
Much more aggressive on that shot. The last shot on the right lane is what we call hit. She hit up on that ball a little bit, and she got the ball out in front of her and hit up on it late and got her fingers into it a little bit too late, caused the ball to hook early. That shot, she stayed down with it a little bit more, was much more aggressive and much better result.
With that spare, Kim Adler has a 16-pin lead. We'll be back with more of the Lady Ebonite Classic semifinal action in a moment. Welcome back to Lexington, Kentucky. Not only do they have the bluegrass, but they have the skyscrapers also. Semifinal match action while we were gone. Everybody clean. One strike for Michelle Feldman. Kim Adler now leads by 13 pins. Michelle now up in the eighth frame, working on a spare, really needed that last strike, but left a 9-pin. Coming light now. Lisa, she's been in the pocket on 13, very high on lane 14 every shot.
Well, I think on 13, right on this shot here, she got a little bit more aggressive, probably because she's been hooking through the head pin and through the nose on 14. But I tell you, Jan, there's not a lot of mistake room out there right now as we see her chop the two off
pin.
The five.
Yeah.
I left every pin this week, believe me, so that's why I'm confused. But
speaking of mistakes, she made one there. And again, you're talking about when she gets more aggressive, her speed picks up. Normally, speaking now again of Michelle Feldman, normally throwing the ball at about 22 miles an hour, trying to keep it down to 17. Meanwhile, Kim Adler up in the eighth frame, working on a spare, leads by 26 pins now. And a real big break for Kim Adler, now high three times in a row in lane 14. Did you see something happening on 14?
Well, I can see the lanes changing a little bit. This oil that we're using this week does have a tendency to move around after a few games. And then it'll set down for a while. Like, she definitely has missed left of her target again. I did see her make a little bit more aggressive shot on that lane this time, and I don't think that was a bad shot at all. I just think she just plain has to move.
Now shooting her spare, the four pin covers it up.
Look at the top 24 and six. Carolyn Doran, 257 her last game, just missed. Collegiate player Jennifer Swanson and Dana Milimaki in 10th.
Kim Kennedy again, the eighth time this year, 11th or higher. Kathy Dorn in the truck doing stats for us. And Wendy McPherson, hey, she is our average leader this year. Kim Adler now up by 25 pins through 8 frames on that disastrous chop by Michelle Feldman. Big setup shot, big break, trip in the 4.
Boy, what an important frame right here for Kim Adler. She makes a really good shot. She does get a good break trip in the 4, but this was a perfect shot for the condition this week. You go high, you do get that 4 pin. She knew she needed that.
Michelle now up in the 9th, desperately needing the strike. She can still strike out for a 207 max score. And that's a big one. Michelle Feldman had a special invite for somebody that I think is very special.
I would like to invite Bill and Hillary Clinton, and Chelsea, of course, to my establishment, Skinny Alice Cedar House Lanes, which is my grandfather's establishment. Please stop in and say hello to my grandfather. It would be very, very grateful on my behalf and see the wonderful town of Skinny Atlas.
Michelle now up in the 10th, trailing by 25 pins. She has to strike out. She can force Kim Adler to mark. Leaving the 10 pin, we had heard that the Clintons are going to Skinny Atlas to vacation. And so Michelle really wants them to come to her bowling center.
Well, I think that would be great if they would. I know that they are involved in all kinds of sports and activities, so it would be great if they did. Well, if we saw Michelle miss a 10 pin, she had a lot of problems with the approach series. I'm laughing about it, but she did make a great shot the first one. Oh. How's that follow through? Little
Whoa.
Hop there at the end.
Yeah. And who says it doesn't take some balance and conditioning to play this sport? These ladies are very strong. Kim Adler now up in the 10th. It's all over, though. Looking good. Still keeping it online. Kim Adler had the right combination today. Michelle Feldman finishes up in 3rd place. Collects $5,200, but it was all Kim Adler. She took down Michelle Feldman, and when we come back, we'll take a look at today's action. We're back, and there's the beautiful Waterford Crystal Trophy that either Leanne Bett or Kim Adler will walk away with today. That the Ebonite Trophy, and it was selected by Bob Reed, the Vice President of Marketing for Ebonite International. At his side is his staff member, Alita Sill, just one of the staff members. And you know we've all talked about the Alita watch, what she needs to break the million. Out of her slump this week, made a check, now needing only $4,383. Could it be next week? Maybe. Right now we're ready for the championship match of the Lady Ebonite Classic, Leanne Bett and Kim Adler. Leanne Bett has elected to start the match.
Twice she had a little bit of a discussion with her ball rep and coach, part-time coach there, Randy Stoughton, and trying to decide if she wanted to start first or let Kim start first. So it was dependent on which lane that was going to be the best for her.
Coming up half pocket, Lisa, she doesn't look too terrible in that shot, although you can see she's hurting.
She is in an incredible amount of pain right now. I talked with her earlier, and she said, she looked at me and she goes, "It hurts."
You can see it all over her face, although on this type of lane condition, if you have to have an injured back, I know this is the best type to have it on. A lot of conditioner, don't have to keep your speed up. Kim Adler, meanwhile, very lined up, looking strong.
So again, she made a move on the right lane in the, at the end of the last game, and it was definitely the right move. She moved her feet further left and kept her target to the left. What she's going to be doing is using that oil and using it as hold to her left, which is the way that pretty much everybody played the lanes this week.
Yeah, almost playing a fallback now. It is incredible, though. 12 straight days of bowling, Pro-Am's competition. She still looks tough. She said she received all kinds of cards. She didn't even want to open them because she didn't want to get caught up in the elation of winning the Open. She wanted to worry about this week. And there's Tommy Adler, Kim's husband, who unfortunately couldn't be on hand for the U.S. Open victory because he was driving the motorhome here to Lexington, Kentucky. Meanwhile, Leanne stepping up in the second frame. Both players flawless. Two titles are ready this year, the Greater Atlanta Open and WIBC Queens title, Leanne's first major. Wow. Well, Lisa asked Leanne about how Evanite rep Randy Stoughton has helped her.
Well, it's always nice to have Randy around. He's been with us a couple weeks this year, and being an Evanite-sponsored event this week, he was here. So he helps me a lot with my equipment. He helps me with my timing. Had a little problem with my back this week, so he's kind of offered a few suggestions, you know, lowering my push away. And it's just overall, it's nice to have a little extra help in the background.
And there's a look at Randy Stoughton as he watches Leanne bowl. I know Leanne also had some help from Del Ballard, who is up here in the booth doing our stats for us today. Coming up light, Lisa, you can just see she can't come through the shot at all.
It's probably very hard for her to stay down right now. The pain is in her lower left back, and it is on her sliding leg right there, so she's feeling it at the very end of her approach.
Yeah, normally Leanne's staying very low and solid to the line. She's popping off her shots, which obviously affects the leverage of her, you know, her leverage position at the line. But it's one game. That's the good thing. She only has to get through one game. Look at it.
Well, normally Leanne is a little bit lower than that. I mean, if you've watched her on previous shows, you will see that she definitely is lower. But, you know, she said she only has one game to bowl. She's just going to grin and bear it.
Well, she stayed with that shot. Kim Adler, 10 events, 10 caches for top five. We talked about that fantastic year she's having. And I wonder if she's caught up on her sleep yet. From the trip here, and she told us she had 4 hours of sleep two nights in a row. Maybe she doesn't need it.
Doesn't look like it. She's got a classic style, just so simple. Just walk by the ball, just push it out and walk by it. Everything's in line, everything's straight, right to her target, very aggressive. She's playing the lanes right now just perfectly for somebody that throws the ball like him does, which is a little bit harder and a little straighter. It's a good lesson for anybody. If the lanes are tight, and Anne-Marie mentioned this to us before, the best thing to do is watch the ball roll over your target. Stay down and watch it hit the target.
Light there, but fortunate to break out the five. At least you're meaning when you're playing a shot that's a little uncomfortable for you.
Just a little bit light here. She got a real good break by only leaving the seven pin here.
Taking her time to convert the spare. And another suggestion I know from when you're trying to play something not comfortable, I think one of the hardest things is to convince yourself that that is what you should be doing, something that's uncomfortable for you. If you can just accept that, it makes it a whole lot easier.
Well, when you stay down, you make a few good shots, and the ball works at the pins, and you strike a few times, you tend to get a little bit more comfortable. If you're not so sure, then you tend to make, you know, a little bit shots that are not so good, and you question yourself.
Well, Leanne Barrett, another player who talked about how she played the lanes, having to use, as you see, sixth appearance this year, having to create a hold left, can't use the right, which is something Leanne likes to use, is the area right.
Well, you could tell that shot right there, it definitely did affect her, the back injury. Came up a little bit early on that shot you saw there. You know, I'll tell you what, it could have been much better than a 4-9. It could have been 9, could have been a strike.
Yeah, very unfortunate to leave the 4-9. And again, though, trying to keep the ball tight, Leanne likes to really project it right, and she's not able to do that today.
Well, the way to make that is you must send the four over into the nine, and it's pretty tough to make any time, much less when the lanes are tough.
Leanne Barrett, also we talked about having a great year through 10 events, including this week, her lowest finish, 17th place. After that, lowest finish, 8th place. Look at the career titles. Who's that leader? I've seen her somewhere. Oh, yeah, next to me. 31, Lisa Wagner. Alita Sill, 30. Patty Costello, 25. Tish Johnson, 22. And Leanne Barrett could tie Tish with that title right here. Oh, now what are the chances of that?
Good reaction by Randy.
Give him some clap about.
There you go.
Trying to encourage her. Give him something to clap about.
Now watch the ball. Just look at that go right through the pins, right through the middle of the 4-9. Nine almost falls, but, you know, she's just not throwing, you know, 100% right now.
Yes, and you shall receive.
Textbook way to make the 4-9 perfect.
Well, we're going to take a quick break, but stay with us because the title's on the line. Do you want to start the millennium off $10,000 richer? You can by becoming a member of the PWBA Bowlers Club. $29.95 gets you an attractive PWBA portfolio, calculator with pen and notebook, a membership card, and a semi-annual newsletter. You are also entered in a daily drawing for $100 and a grand prize drawing on Christmas Day for $10,000. Call the PWBA office toll-free at 1-800-426-8823. Or you can also email us at pwbaoffice@aol.com. While we were gone, Kim Adler continued to strike, has the lead by 39 pins, and the last time she won back-to-back titles was in 1996, the Lady Emmeline Open and the Hammer Players Championship. Canton, Michigan and Rockford, Illinois, and she is, for all practical purposes, on her way to doing that right now.
That's right, she looks very strong right now. She's playing the lanes the way she needs to, and she's staying down, making good shots. It's aggressive right now.
49-pin lead now with the strike in the seventh. Leanne Barrett, how unfortunate, very evident, her back injury hindering her performance here today. But Kim Adler, not leaving it to question, throwing almost nothing but strikes. Oh, coming up high on that one.
A little quick with the feet, I think, on that one. Didn't take quite as much time. A little bit quicker early in her approach. And hey, that's what happens to most of us when our start is messed up, so is the rest of the shot.
Kim taking a little bit of time again on the 3-6-10. I remember Lisa last time she shot this, she caught it on the inside instead of the right side and got the break off the wall, with the 6-pin off the wall to take out the 10. See how she shoots it this time. That's the way you're supposed to do it.
Yeah, I think she flattened out the ball just a little bit more. She got her hand up underneath and behind the ball a little bit more. Didn't want it to hook at all, left no room for a chop there.
Leanne Barrett now up in the eighth frame, working on a strike. She has a max score still of 230. Kim Adler, max score of 256. Well, even an easy spare, but she just can't project the ball down the lane the way she needs to right now.
Stayed down pretty good on this shot, but, you know, she's a little bit slower, and her timing is going to be a little bit off right now because of this back injury, and I could see that her foot was there a little bit earlier than it normally is, and, you know, timing-wise, she's just not going to be real crisp, but hey, no wonder when you got, like, you know, a knife stabbing you in the back when you're trying to throw a shot.
Covers that spare nicely.
There in 16th, we see making a strong comeback from elbow surgery, Carol Giannotti Block. Great coach, Carol Norman, Linda Kelly in 20th.
Jeannie Nacarado, part-time now bowling. Tiffany Stambrough, she's the top rookie this year. And, well, Lisa, somebody has to hold up the bottom of the field.
And that would be me.
Good job, too. Good job. And you fought hard for that zero. You got back to even.
Yes, I did. Had to get 8 on the fill ball to get... I wanted the big E.
And trying to correct for the problem of pulling the shot, sailing that one right, missing the head pin. I can feel for I have been there way too many times with back problems, and there's nothing you can do.
No, there isn't. It's just, you know, she's just going to have to go through a little program here of rehab. She's going to have to put some ice on that and get the swelling out of that and go through a little bit of exercising here when it does heal a little.
Covers the spare. And Randy's rooting around on the field, and that's about all he can do is give her a little bit of moral support.
Well, you know, she got here. She got the first, and she said last night that it's a good thing she had a pretty sizable lead before the last game of match play because she could barely walk.
Four pin, but she knows, just okay, I'm just keeping it in play.
It's just academic right now. She turned early on that shot. Her hand came around that ball quite a bit earlier than the rest, but, you know, hey, when you've got a lot of oil to the left, you can use that. So the ball did get down the lane pretty good, left herself with only a four pin.
Right, she covers it up and just going through the motions here. Kim Adler's pretty happy with this summer at this point in time. There you see, really, this match is over. Leanne Barrett can only shoot a possible 196. Kim Adler already with 205 if she didn't make the shot she just did. Big smile out of Kim Adler. Now this one, she's going to have time to let it set in before she has to head on down to Chattanooga.
She just wants to get out of there right now, finish it, take her 235 here if she spares, and run with the check.
Well, Kim Adler wins back-to-back for the second time in her career. Covers it nicely. She's claimed victory over all the rest in the Lady Ebonite Classic, and we're coming right back. We're going to chat with Kim Adler. Stay with us.